Well, let me show you something, my friend. Someone turned me on to a couple of clips over the weekend, and I couldn't get enough. You know how we just love the old shows from the 70s and 80s, like Happy Days and Laverne and Shirley, especially after they got away with the pesky entertaining episodes of the first few seasons and were completely lost as to what to do for material. So they decided to try to make stars of these people in their own right with dancing and singing and whatnot. And it could perhaps be some of the most embarrassing things you'd ever see. We all know Carmine from Laverne and Shirley was a song and dance man on Laverne and Shirley. Even early on, he'd bust into their apartment, rape them, and then sing an Italian tune of sort. I don't know if he raped them, but and it was sort of his character, and that was one thing. It's like that's just one part, and then he'd leave. Well, after, I guess, Shirley left, and it was just Laverne, and even Lenny and Squiggy left, I guess. I don't know. Maybe no, Squiggy's in this.
Yeah, Mike McKean left. I know that.
Yeah, yeah. They decided to try to make Carmine a thing. Do you remember there was a dance called Do the Carmine? Do you remember this?
Oh, dear.
Dude, I am fucking like, when I saw this, first of all, just the way it's filmed like they film Joni Loves Chachi, like they tried to make it look like a music video or something. And I honestly think whoever the Goomba fucking Jadrul that plays Carmine is actually thought like, no, I think I'm going to get somewhere with this. Like when they let Anson Williams sing, I'm sure Anson Williams thought, oh, finally, I'm not just going to be Potsy. I'm going to be a singer. I'm going to be the singer Potsy. And it all, of course, goes to... Nothing comes of it because it's so terrible. This is the dance. It's introed, by the way, by a man you might know, Jay Leno, with a head of black hair. Jay Leno introing Do the Carmine from Laverne and Shirley.
New dance making its world premiere.
Hold on to your hats, people.
When the history books write the story of rock and roll, this cat's going to be chapter one. Here's Carmine doing Do the Carmine.
Oh, you ready? Why would you watch this if you wanted to watch Laverne and Shirley?
Why would you watch this if you wanted to watch a comedy?
Yeah, yeah. And soak my cock. Look, they thought it was going to be a thing. What's he doing?
Oh, God. Put your hands together. Wiggle your
toes. Jiggle your feet. And kick your ass. Oh, he's showing us how to do it.
Oh,
Laverne didn't have a bad body on. She got that nice legs in that dress. Never noticed that. Well, I'm not looking at Carmine's ass cheeks squeezed into his leather pants.
I'm surprised they're not ripping.
Oh, is it like Saturday Night Fever? Was that around the same time? I bet it was.
No, it's not like there's a flow to it. He's just moving his arms. And,
yeah.
It's not a dance. It's just insane.
Oh,
oh, God.
Oh. Dude, how fucking embarrassing is it? He's doing the karma. Do you think anyone at the clubs were doing the Carmine back when this came out? It's a dance that's going to sweep the nation.
Yeah, they did it on Soul Train later that week.
He was beat up. He was knifed and slashed.
Yeah,
and
he did the Carmine.
His little toddler was punched in the face because he was doing the Carmine. God damn. Do
Why?
The Carmine. Well, look, maybe we don't have to blame Laverne and Shirley because in Happy Days,
yes,
there was an episode where they actually did the Fonzie.
Oh, that I do remember. Absolutely.
But it's not the one where he does the Russian dance.
No, it's the thumb one.
Yes.
Oh,
I
remember.
The thumb one.
Not only that, I had a record. I still have it with him on it.
You have a record for driving drunk with a car on fire.
Yeah. Most of the records I have.
That record.
I'd rather have that record than the Fonzie record.
The Fonzie. This is another one that's just like, why did they decide these things? This is well after the Shark Jump episode, or it would have been called, oh, that episode did the Fonzie.
Yes.
Like, if there was no Shark Jump episode, this would have been the one where they went, oh, yeah, Howard Stern did the Fonzie a long time ago.
A long time ago.
Yeah, but it's jumped the shark. All right, let's get a little do the Fonzie.
Oh, God, I remember this. It's so bad.
So bad.
Oh, no. Yep.
You gotta put your thumbs back. And Henry Winkler has no clue what to do.
No.
Like, I'm not gonna dance. I'm just a short Jewish guy playing a greaser in the 70s.
Yeah, he's like, I have horrible Asperger's that hasn't been identified yet.
Oh, who's this pedophile? That guy looked like a kid toucher for sure.
Oh, he was.
Oh, we're all doing the Fonzie. Oh, the thumbs. And Pinky Tuscadero's playing. No, Leather.
There's several people here who wouldn't be allowed in the same building at that time.
Oh, yeah.
It's just not historically accurate. Dude,
How did they put this on? We had nothing else to watch.
They tried to make that into a big thing, though.
Yeah. It didn't turn into a big thing.
Like, I don't even want to emulate it.
Do people think they were going to be doing the Fonzie or the Carmine?
It's hard to pick which one you want to impress your date with.
It really is. Well, if you have a little more of a country twang to your preference, then you probably saw around this very time the episode of Chips where Ponch square dances. Ponch and the Chips guys, the captain or
Eric
the sergeant. Eric Estrada, the Mexican guy, is square dancing with a bunch of hillbillies.
So
it's business. Ask a Trare, all right?
Trare, does he know how to square dance?
If he doesn't, Ponch can teach him.
That's right. Oh. Like, Ponch would be strung up at this place.
Oh, yeah.
Who's the Puerto Rican? Oh, no. They're doing a cop show, and then they get the script and go, wait, I dance in this? Why am I dancing?
Like, just put on your leather vest.
Like, this isn't the... Does someone break in and we shoot them? No, it's just you dancing. You're square dancing. Why? I would have to ask as an actor why, but I guess Ponch didn't ask anything. He just took the check.
This was actually an episode of Chico and the Man.
Look at them. This guy doesn't want to do this. He doesn't want to do this.
No one wants to do
this. He's like the lieutenant, right?
Why is there an Asian guy?
It's not very diverse. Yeah, we're gonna need Soundstage 7 today. Chips is there? Oh, what are you gonna bring some motorcycles in there and do? No, it's square dancing. Why? Yeah, we don't know. Oh my God,
sure.
They're dressed like fucking Brokeback Mountain.
Yeah, one of the writers has been high on coke for 4 days and just brought this script.
Yeah, so. He's been on a bender. He had nothing. So he just decided to do a square dancing episode on a fucking motorcycle cop show.
He figured he could kill 8 minutes of network time by just having the square dance.
Oh, is this terrible? Girls don't even look hot dressed like this or anything. It's
no.
Like, they can't. And it all looks gay. Look at the gay mustache guy.
Did you see the guy in the pink?
Yeah.
other guy back there has a neckerchief on.
There it is. Oh. There's your episode of Chips. I don't know what they thought. Like, oh, get out there, you! Oh,
come on,
oh,
go in there.
Jerk
dance.
Off on him. Yeah, they circle all... jerk around and. Oh yeah, show Punch's dick.
Oh,
is he gonna? This is like Saturday Night Fever.
Oh, look,
what's he doing? He's doing a solo.
He's doing the Carmine.
He's doing the Carmine. Wait, he's smacking the dog shit off of his boots.
Yes.
Again, they push him out. Oh, he's got to teach him.
He's reaching for a knife because he knows somebody's gonna come at him in the bathroom.
Yeah. Now do this like you're stomping on a perp's neck with your boots, and then wipe the DNA off your boots.
Yeah.
That's how this works.
Nobody knows what it is yet, so we can do just about anything.
Oh my god.
Look at this.
Ugh. How long does it, like, this is, and think about it. America is sitting in their living rooms going.
Imagine being in the studio audience and how disappointed you would be.
Oh, yeah. That is terrible. They went through a phase, like every show has their special episodes, you know, with the child molestation and drugs. They went through a phase where every show had to have a song and dance number. And they're terrible. They're
well, the
just
Brady
terrible.
Bunch became a singing group.
Yes, they became the Brady Bunch variety show, which made no sense because they were still acknowledging each other as the Brady characters. But why would they have a Vegas show? Like what happened in the Brady Bunch world where they went from the father being an architect to the mother being a homemaker, the maid, and the kids going to school, to all of a sudden it's going, well, kids, pack up. We missed that episode. We're all going to Vegas to be faggot show people.
Yeah, come on.
I
There's
gotta
a
get
lot
in
of us.
Somewhere, kids. <It's> a...
I need to keep you kids by me in a hotel room because I can't touch your mother anymore for certain reasons.
And there they were, like doing song and dance numbers as the Bradys. This mm-hmm. is
it was ridiculous.
Oh, it's so bad. And Jan's the only one with sense. Eve Plum said, go fuck your mother. I will not be party to this. Then they do. That's the Jan.
Oh, all the
girl.
Lip syncing.
The fake Jan.
This is called the No Residual Dancers.
They got a girl that could kind of sing with her because the Brady kids are incapable of carrying a tune. It's amazing. Oh. All of them are terrible. Look at the dance.
Greg can rap.
Oh, Greg can rap. We heard that.
Oh, yeah.
He does, I'm Greg Brady. I'm the real Brady. Oh, and now... What is she doing? Applause, the diamondy lights. What happened? Like, what did we miss in the Brady Bunch that got them here?
Also, the mom character. Oh, no. Oh, no.
How bad is this?
He's dressed like John Holmes in one of his final roles. Look at how.
Well, he died just like John Holmes in his final role. They. Oh, disco? Oh, no. Who's this?
No.
Oh, he's doing a Michael Jackson song. Yeah! Just fake applause. There's no audience there. Better enjoy
yourself. So it's just clown wig?
He's so serious, by the way. He is so fucking deadly serious doing this.
Oh, yeah.
He thought this was going to launch his next career. As Johnny Bravo. Oh, he was off right there. Did you hear?
Oh,
they can't even get the lip syncing right. Oh, no. Oh, no. It's Rick Dees with the disco duck. Oh, my God.
No.
This has to be the biggest douche chill episode of any show ever. Rick Dees was a radio DJ back in the disco days, and he made a song called The Disco Duck.
Oh, yeah.
And it became very popular, and he should have been put up against the wall and shot for it.
Why do they have to have a child playing the duck.
Well, someone's got to get fucked.
Well, that's really what it is, though.
Oh, my God.
Oh, it's Rip Taylor.
Rip Taylor. And Alice the Maid. This makes no sense. This was
Mr.
acid.
Brady's,
someone was
Mr.
on acid.
Mr. Brady's jizz is drying on his feathers.
Sherwood Schwartz's son. Oh, my God,
it's rerun.
Hey, no, it's all of them. They're diverse.
Rerun.
They have the What's Happening kids. Look at rerun.
With moves they like just, that, I'm surprised he was so heavy.
Yeah. All right, yeah, we got rid of that. Okay, that check mark on black people. We include everybody here on the Brady Bunch.
Well, they needed to show actual dancers or people with the ability to.
Why
Look
are they doing the I Love Lucy song? They're la-la-ing the I Love Lucy theme song.
Mr. Brady is just moving like he's in pain.
Well, he probably is.
Yeah.
I'm surprised he's wearing those white pants. You think the back of it would look like the Japanese flag?
It's probably just... It's probably got a lot of gauze back there.
Oh, and now everyone comes out for the big finale.
Oh, that's exciting.
Yeah, Ricky. Yeah! Wow!
What
a performance, Doc! What a... Oh, the reprieve. They keep going. And now the confetti and the anal sex. And can you fucking believe that was on network primetime television?
How many blue-collar guys just threw a beer bottle through the television watching that? Just furious.
Oh, is that the worst? Just the worst. I can't imagine a network executive greenlighting that and it actually making it onto the television screen of people's homes back in those days. Was that 77, I guess?
Yeah, it just... Yeah, it's good. What do you want to dance? All of the Bradys? Okay.
Yeah, we'll get them, the Bradys. I'll get that. What do you want? Rerun? You want those kids too? Fine. Rick Deeds, Disco Duck. We got them.
Like, hey, is there a kid in a duck suit I can see
the
dance?
Child in a duck suit.
I got a kid in my office that always waddles out of here anyway. Right, you might as well slap a duck costume on him.
And then the fucking the stage hand or the just bitter people that work at ABC were probably just like, all right, bring on the kids from What's Happening. They're next. Rick Dees, is he in the duck suit? Do we got him in the duck suit? We're just disgusted. He's watched actual brilliance and genius on that stage, and that's what you get. Oh, what a pathetic mess.
Didn't Rick Dees blow up the disco in the baseball field?
No, that was the guy in Chicago.
Oh, that wasn't Rick. He was
Steve
blowing
Dahl.
Up Rick Dees, I guess.
It was Steve Dahl in Chicago.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. No, Rick Dees was a DJ, and then he had this song, Disco Duck.
It's a huge hit.
It got huge. It's funny because they use it in Saturday Night Fever, but it's the lamest thing. Like, it's that smarmy, slimy disco dance studio owner. And he's got like old people in front of him and he's going teaching them how to disco dance. And they're going, disco, disco duck, teaching them to disco duck. It's just always been the worst tune ever. But Rick Dees apparently made millions of.